water cooling system of HHP locomotive. Purpose of cooling water system. Cooling water system in HHP locomotive is a closed loop pressurized water. It maintains a uniform level of temperature throughout the engine. It reduces thermal load of engine component by dissipating heat to atmosphere. It cools all engine cylinder liners, cylinder heads, after coolers, low-wide coolers, and air compressors mainly. Advantages of pressurized cooling water system in HHP locomotive. The cooling water system is pressurized to increase the boiling point of coolant or water. This in turn permits higher engine operating temperature. It also helps in preventing cavitations at the water pumps during high transient temperature conditions. It provides uniform cooling throughout the operating range of the diesel engine. The possibilities of losses of coolant water is very less because in case of vaporization, there is no scope of its escape. Components of cooling water system in HHP locomotive. The following components play their vital roles in a smooth operation of cooling water system of HHP locomotives. These are two number centrifugal water pump mounted on a series drive housing at front end of main engine and it driven by governor drive gear. Its discharge pressure is 30 to 50 psi. Second, two number main header. Each header is provided at left and right bank of engine. Third, two number after coolers located on each side of turbocharger to cool the air entering to the airbox for each bank of the engine. Fourth, one number water outlet manifold. Fifth, four number roof mounted radiator core. Sixth, two number radiator fan driven by AC motor assembly. This AC motor gets power from companion alternator. Seventh, one number low-wide cooler. Eighth, one number expansion tank. Its capacity is 371 liters and total capacity of cooling water system is 1045 liters. Components water cooling system. In this slide, the location of two number water pump may be clearly seen. It is mounted on accessories drive housing at front end of main engine. The location of water inlet manifold may also be seen inside air box, which is connected to outlet of water pump. Layout of cooling water system. In this slide, the basic layout of cooling water system is shown and the name of the component are also indicated here. So please refer it and try to understand the working function what I am going to explain here. The yellow color indicates the flow of coolants or water. When engine is started, two water pump which rotates in the opposite direction of the engine crankshaft draw coolant from the expansion tank and discharge to the water inlet manifold located in the each airbox. Further, coolant from the water manifold is supplied to each cylinder liner individually with the help of water inlet tube assembly. Consequently, coolant flows upward in the cylinder liner water jacket and enter to the cylinder head. From each cylinder head, coolant come to the water outlet manifold. Since the water inlet manifold is connected to after cooler at rear end, so coolant coming out from the after cooler is also collected in the water outlet manifold in the top center of the engine. Now, coolant is directed out from water outlet manifold to the radiator assemblies. Here, in radiator assembly, coolant loses its heat and becomes cool. AC motor driven radiator fans moves here air through the radiator core. The coolant returns from the radiator core to the Luwile cooler, where it is observes some of the excess heat from the Luwile. From the Luwile cooler, the coolant goes back to the water pump to repeat the cycle. In this way, we can say the water circulating in engine basically cools the cylinder liner, cylinder head, after cooler, Luwile cooler, and further it also cools air compressor, because one branch line which is connected from outlet of the water pump is going to the air compressor. EPD, or low water and crankcase pressure detector. In this slides, two knobs may be seen as indicated. The upper knob is related to water cooling system and lower knob is concerned to crankcase vacuum of engine. If abnormal harmful conditions exist in the cooling water system and crankcase pressures, the device will shut down the engine. So let us discuss on upper knob first, which is called as low water pressure detector. In this device, there is a diaphragm which is balanced by water pump discharge pressure and air box pressure. When water pump discharge pressures become less than the air box pressure, the diaphragm moves and this device trips. This device may trip because of low water level, excessive coolant temperature, and exhaust gases in the cooling system. This low water detector may also trip when the cooling system is drained. Now let us discuss on lower knob. This is related to the crankcase pressure detector. It will trip only when positive pressure is built up in crankcase. Because of this also, engine will shut down. This device is already been discussed in the previous slide. Thanks to all of you for watching and listening this video.